Welcome back, Trader Troops. So crypto.com, I'm here with another update. As always, I keep you guys updated with the latest and greatest cryptocurrency technical analysis on the internet. I'm going to run you down through my technicals today, going to tell you where I think it's headed next, so make sure you watch till the very end. As always, make sure to smash that like button and subscribe and hit that bell notification icon so you never miss another post, because I do post in real time, so it's very easy to miss one of my updates. So let's get into the video. So crypto.com, we've all heard of it by now, was up over 1,000% at one point off of its lows. It's had an insane bull run recently, but what will it be doing next? So if we take a look at the daily time frame, first thing that I've done is I just took a Fibonacci retracement tool, went from that low to that high, and now we have a bunch of levels of support, right? Just how we always use the Fibonacci retracement tool. What we're going to see is that we clearly have topped out in the short term, right? So what's going to be the first level of support as far as Fibonacci retracements are concerned? The 382. The 382 is going to act as the first level of Fibonacci support, and that gives us a target of roughly 62 cents. So theoretically speaking, on the daily time frame, 62 cents is the target for this short-term pullback. Now, if we take a look at RSI, we're going to see that RSI is currently trending downwards. Now, we're still trading above the 50 or the midpoint on the RSI, which technically speaking means that we are still in an uptrend. But when we take a look at the overall price action on RSI, we've seen this massive dip here. We topped out at a level that we usually top out at, which is roughly 92-ish. Okay, so just because we're above that 50 level does not necessarily mean that we have to go up in price. We could still easily pull back. In fact, we're more likely to retest this midpoint, which means price to drop a little bit more. We're more likely to retest that 50 point than to curl back up, in my opinion, right now. So let's drop down to a smaller time frame like the 4-hour time frame and get a little more into detail here, okay? So we're going to see this level of support, which should be no surprise to you if you watched my last videos, which I assume most of you guys have. If you haven't, just make sure to smash that subscribe button. Okay, we're going to see this level of support right in here. This is the level that we assumed was going to hold, and it did for a short period of time. We got about a 20% bounce off of that, and that's why you do smash that subscribe button so you didn't miss that. Okay, but now we're kind of retesting that level of support. And if we take a look at the RSI once again, we're going to see that we have been slowly downtrending, and in fact, we have been unable to break back above that 50 level or the midpoint and hold that level for very long, okay, which is actually a very bearish sign, the fact that we are not able to start trading above that midpoint, and the fact that we're about to come back down below these RSI lows here, it tells us that we may need to go oversold on the RSI before any meaningful bounces in the future. Now, we still are technically speaking in a big level of support. Okay, what makes this an area of support? Well, we have the 382 Fibonacci retracement. The daily 382 is sitting right here, again, roughly at around 62. Then we also have plenty of reactions in this zone. Now, the reason why I think we may need to go a little bit lower down to 62 cents, and why I don't think we're going to really be able to hold too much longer in this $67, $68 range is because when we drop down to the 1-hour time frame, all right, we're going to see that every time that we kind of try to bounce at this area, we get sold right back down, okay? And this is a little bit more advanced stuff. If you want to learn everything that I know, just make sure to check out the Measuring Markets program, where I teach you 8 years worth of experience summarized in 2 1-hour sessions every single week. In fact, we have one today, so make sure to check that out. Okay, so we'll see if we zoom in onto the price action here, we're going to see that if you think about it in the terms of buyers and sellers and who's winning the battle, okay, when we take a look at this bounce right in here, we're going to see that it's comprised of mostly green candles, one red candle, but mostly green candles, but guess what? They're very small green candles. So that tells us that this is very weak buying. Now we take a look at the move back down, and what do we see? We see 3 red candles, and 3 red candles pretty much got rid of all of these small green candles' progress to the upside. So that tells us that sellers are very, very, very strong, and that they're willing to sell at very early prices as well, because we really did not bounce much higher, right? So if we know that we're not able to get much ground here, and we're at a level of support where this should be holding, where buyers should be buying aggressively, and they're not, that tells us that there's probably not a lot of buying pressure in the top range of this level of support, and that buying pressure is probably going to be found a little bit deeper into this level of support, aka back down towards the 62 cent range on crypto.com. Okay, so personally, I would not be buying here. I mean, it still is a level of support, don't get me wrong. It still is a level of support, but personally, my intuition is telling me that we may need to go a little bit lower first, given the what we saw on the RSI, given what we saw on the price action. If you're already holding crypto.com, in my opinion, if I was already holding crypto.com, I would just continue to hold it. If you are looking to buy crypto.com, if I was looking to buy crypto.com, I would probably hold off just a little bit longer and wait to buy a little bit lower, in my opinion, not financial advice. So thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure to smash that like button and subscribe and hit that bell notification icon if you're new, because I do post the latest and greatest cryptocurrency technical analysis in real time every single day. So thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Peace.